Popup forms can help grow your audience and send more personalized campaigns. Use our no-code editor to customize your design. Then set rules so that visitors to your website get the most relevant form. To get started, head to Forms and click Popup Forms. Next, click Create Popup Form. And you'll be asked, what would you like to offer? Even if you're thinking of a general newsletter, consider offering an incentive. It could be a free consultation or free content like an ebook for first-time visitors. You know, anything that shows people the value of signing up to your list. If you're selling products, it never hurts to throw in a discount. That's what we'll choose for this example, and we'll click Continue. After you decide what you want to offer, you'll go to our template library. Feel free to browse templates based on different offers. The current filter is for discount, but you could click Event or Webinar Signup, Contest or Giveaway, whatever you need. To get a better idea of what's in a template, click Preview. We suggest previewing a few templates to make sure you find the right design and incentive. That way, you'll save some time in editing. For example, you won't have to take a step back to switch from a newsletter to free content. When you want to move forward with a template, click Apply. For the next couple of steps, you'll name your form, choose your audience, and select fields. Let's spend a bit of time talking about fields. To put it simply, this is the data you want to collect from potential clients, customers, or donors. We'll just choose the field for email. You can add a field to collect SMS phone numbers, but you'll need to set up an SMS-ready audience. To get started with that, you'll have to submit an SMS marketing application, and then if it's approved, you'll be able to send out marketing text messages. Now that the fields are set, let's click Create Form to start building. Welcome to our editor. Everything's highly customizable and it doesn't take any code. Swap out images, add your logo, and change the colors and fonts to meet your needs. You know, really make it yours. After you design your form, click Review Settings to move on to the checklist. You can work through the steps in any order. Here's where you'll need to choose or add the site where the pop-up will be displayed. Keep in mind, each pop-up can only be published on one site. If you haven't connected a site to Mailchimp yet, click Resolve and then add a site. Let's say you have a Shopify store. Click Use Shopify and Add Integration. That brings up the Shopify integration page. From here, click Get Started and follow the steps to add your store. After that, return to the window with the checklist and click Close to use your connected site. That's how you add a Shopify store. But your site might be built on another platform, or it's custom coded. In that case, click Manually Connect Site and then Manually Connect. Now, enter your site's URL. Choose an audience in Mailchimp to connect your site to, and click Get Code Snippet. You'll need to copy and paste this code between the head tags on your website. When you're done with that, return to this step and click Check Connection to make sure it's working. If you don't want your form to show up on all of your site's web pages, click Add or Exclude Target Pages. In this example, let's exclude the checkout page. So, set conditions like currently viewing page, URL path, that doesn't contain any of these. Enter /checkout, and you've got it. The pop-up will only appear on pages that don't have /checkout in the URL path. When you're happy with your setup, click Save. Next up is, who should see it? So click Edit Targeting. Effective targeting helps you give people the right content, and it stops someone from interacting with the same pop-up over and over. The rules you set are based on our pre-built visitor rules for anonymous visitors and already known visitors. To refine your targeting, click Add Condition, and you'll be able to set conditions like traffic source or geolocation. If a person meets the condition of your rules, they'll get the pop-up form. Make sense? All right, let's save. Head to When Should It Show? And click Edit Triggers. In this step, you'll set a trigger for how soon the pop-up will appear. Let's say 2 seconds after the visitor lands on the page. And that's about it. Just don't forget to save. Now, we're on to Advanced Settings. After you click Edit Settings, you'll notice we have set you up with some good defaults. But you can tweak your targeting even more and control how frequently your pop-up appears. You could also decide how your form interacts with other pop-ups, like if it should replace them. So with that, we've covered the checklist. If you need to make any final edits to your design before publishing, head to the What Should It Look Like step. If you're good to go, click Publish or Schedule. Maybe you don't want to publish right away, so choose Schedule and set a start date. If you want to pause or stop your form on a particular date, pick a stop date and click Schedule to wrap things up. Good work. You can keep track of who signs up here on the form's details page. For your next steps, try targeting contacts with a message based on the incentive in your form. Or you could use the data you collected to send a personalized message.